Hey everybody, it's Ishra Sharif for thestylespy.com on Novus TV. We're here at the St. Regis Hotel today in downtown Vancouver to check in with the great music artist, Lady Gaga. I wanna kiss you, but if I do, then I might miss you, babe. How do you take the blend of fashion and music and pop culture right now? Always in different songs of any genre of music, they're always name dropping labels and talking about different designers or doing their own thing. How important do you think that is?
Well, I think that is great. But I think what's more important is that you embody the lifestyle of the fashion that you sing about. For me, this record, when I say fashion is my life, I could never have written this album without fashion, without New York, without the way that me and my friends rode around New York City, as if we're famous, but we're not.
Well, that was one of the things. You wrote the fame and all the lyrics and stuff like that before, you know, you went so-called mainstream, so you're already talking about those sorts of things, and now it's all happening for you. For example, all the designs that you have on stage right now, I've been told that you designed them all yourself.
For the Fame Ball, yes, but they're inspired by other designers, so I cannot take the sole credit. The opening outfit is inspired by Thierry Mugler. Mm-hmm. It doesn't look exactly like anything he ever made, but it uses similar shapes and is reinvented for the year 2009.
Yeah, it's completely uber futuristic fab, kind of like the bubble dress. Where did you get the inspiration for that one?
That is almost an exact copy of a Hussein Shalayan dress, which is in a museum somewhere right now. I redid the dress slightly different. Instead of using bandages underneath, we did it with a more nude, shiny spandex material, so that when I would stand and was backlit, you could see the silhouette of my body and the bubbles, and I would effectively look naked, covered in whimsy soap.
Do you ever see yourself doing your own line?
Yeah.
Yeah? Will you call it House of Gaga?
No.
No? What would you call it?
Something else.
Where did you get the idea for Gaga Vision Transmission?
Well, I don't like blogging. I think it ruins the mystery of the artist. I don't really want people to care too much about what I think of anything other than art and fashion and music. Mm-hmm. And I think sometimes artists can get comfortable blogging, except for Kanye. Kanye's very good.
Speaking of Kanye, he came to your show last week in LA. You two fashionistas on a track together would be amazing. Is there anything like that that could ever happen in the future?
You never know.
You never know. And getting back to Gaga Vision Transmission, there's that one-liner that always opens up the webisodes. Lady Gaga was sent to Earth to infiltrate human culture one sequin at a time. What is behind that one-liner?
Well, it's a bit humorous and nerdy. And it's meant to explain the very visual element of who I am, and that it's not just about the music. It's about the lifestyle. And I guess you could say I liken my lifestyle to a secret. I wanna hold them like they do in Texas, please. Fold them, let them hit me, raise it, baby, stay with me.
Perez Hilton is calling you the new pop of Princess. How do you feel about that?
Princess of Pop.
Princess of Pop.
He's very sweet.
Yeah.
He's very sweet. I'm very grateful to him. But to tell you the truth, I like him whether or not he says those nice things about me. Mm-hmm. He's one of the most, whether anyone believes it or not, one of the most down-to-earth celebrities that I've met, and I don't really like celebrities.
That's insightful about Perez Hilton. Nobody would really think that.
I love that nail polish color.
Thank you.
Where did you get that?
It's Essie. What is it called? Hot Pants, I think?
Very good.
Thank you. I'm going to throw a bunch of just quick questions at you. Who is your favorite designer?
Oh, Chanel.
And your favorite celebrity with style? Or inspiration, either living, present, past?
Morrissey.
And what do you indulge in the most? I know you like sunglasses, but anything else?
Sunglasses.
Sunglasses. And what is a beauty product that you cannot live without?
Eyelashes.
Eyelashes.
fake. Very fake.
And
I love things that are fake.
I guess we have to ask you this one last question. The no pants thing. I already know why, because you say that you're more comfortable just not wearing pants. What do you have to say to everybody about it?
It's very strange, to be completely honest. There's a lot of pop singers that don't wear pants.
It's true. Beyonce's never in pants. Madonna's never in pants. You kind of just choose to work your offstage into that as well.
Well, here's the thing. Is for me, it's not stage clothes and then outside clothes.
Exactly.
I have always been this way. I'm quite a bit excited, or maybe a bit nervous as well, for old photographs of me from my partying days in New York to surface, because I've been wearing no pants for a very long time. And it's very 70s.
Mm-hmm.
It's very freeing. It's nothing more than a fashion statement.
Was it too cold in Vancouver for that today?
No, I won't be wearing any pants later.
So there you have it, everything that you needed to know about Lady Gaga. We're going to cut to Chris real quick for a quick tip from Blow.
Hi, I'm Chris, style director from Blow Blow Dry Bar, and today I'm going to be showing you guys how to do perfect flat iron curls. A lot of people don't know that you can actually curl with a flat iron, and the curls actually last a lot longer and are a lot stronger. So all you do is you stick your flat iron in just as if you're going to straighten it, except you turn the flat iron about 90 degrees and then you slowly pull it through, holding onto the ends so it goes through nice and steadily. And you have a perfect flat iron curl.
To keep up to date on everything Gaga, hit up LadyGaga.com. As always, I'm Ishra Sharif for TheStyleSpy.com on Novus TV.